Hello, Lakers Nation. It's game day. Lakers versus Grizzlies game two tonight. Plenty to talk about as we get ready for this matchup. Make sure you come join us over on Playback for the game. We will be there live. Playback.tv/Lakers Nation. I'm also dropping the link in the description down below. You can watch the game directly with us. Hang out while we watch the Lakers take on the Grizzlies. Joining me, as always, is Mark Gunnels from LakersNation.com. Mark, opportunity for the Lakers to go up 2-0 in the series. What needs to happen for them to get it done?
Yeah, so obviously there's a big cloud over if Ja Morant is going to play or not. They list him as a game-time decision. My hunch, no source, obviously, I think he's not going to play. I think it's better for him to get the extra few days of rest because game three is not until Saturday. It's another two-game layoff there. So I think that could do him some justice there. And not to mention, this Grizzlies team, they've won plenty of games without Ja, not only this year, but last year as well. So they feel comfortable, I think, in that spot with Tyus Jones, who I think is the best backup point guard in the league. I think he could start for a few teams as well. So I think they could still feel like they can win this game. Now, for the Lakers angle here, you can't take this team lightly. Obviously, the playoffs, so you would hope that's never the case in the playoffs, right? But there's still some human nature there without a potential Ja Morant in the lineup to where, you know, you think you got this in the bag. You beat him pretty much with Ja. I know he missed the last 5 minutes or so of that game, but he was there for the majority of that contest. So, you know, take care of business. You did win the one game on the road. We always say you got to at least win one, right? But why not be greedy, Trevor? Why not try to go up 2-0, come back to L.A., and you should at least win one of those games? And you're looking at being up 3-1 potentially. Worst case scenario if you win tonight, because I don't think you'll lose two games in LA. So why not get greedy tonight? Take care of business. I think crashing the boards will be very huge tonight, not allowing Memphis to get second chance opportunities. And then obviously stopping them in transition, make them score in the half court, which should be a little easier if Ja doesn't play, because he's the guy that's really pushing the tempo for that team. Tyus Jones is not nearly the athlete that Ja Morant is. So make him play in the half court and bank on your defense, right? You have the number one ranked defense since the trade. So I think if you can do those two things, I think you can get away with this game and go up 2-0 heading back to L.A.
Yeah, I think they have a great opportunity to do just that. You know, right now the lines are even in terms of Lakers versus Grizzlies. There isn't a favorite here, which actually I think says a lot. Because typically in this scenario, the home team would be a fairly heavy favorite. I mean, backs against the wall, they're desperate because they can't go down 0-2 at home. Like, that's like, you can't go down 0-2 in a series in general. But if you're going down 0-2 and you're the road team, okay, you go back home, you take care of business at home. Next thing you know, it's a 2-2 series. You go down 0-2 when you're at home and then you have to travel to LA. That is a very difficult spot to be in. So Memphis, I'm expecting them to come out guns blazing, doing everything they can do to get this win, whether Ja Morant is on the floor or not. And the fact that it's even right now tells you that the Lakers really do have a good shot here in this one, despite the desperation that the Grizzlies are certain to play with. The Lakers are going to have to match that. But you know what? Typically, we talk about playoff series in terms of adjustments, right? That's what we see. We see adjustments, then adjustments to those adjustments. Typically, the team that loses game one, they're the team that has the most significant adjustments in game two. So how the Lakers adapt on the fly to the different things that the Grizzlies throw at them in this game, that's going to be critical. And that's going to be something I'm going to watch in this game. I do think that we're going to see them cover Austin Reeves, who blew up against them in the fourth quarter. Rui Hachimura, who had 29 points. A little bit differently in this one. The Grizzlies really sold out to try to prevent the ball from getting to LeBron or getting to AD, and they still did plenty of damage. But I do wonder if there's a little bit more space to operate for LeBron and for Anthony Davis in this game, now that the Grizzlies saw in game one that they can't just dare Rui Hachimura, Austin Reeves, D'Angelo Russell, players like that to beat them, because they will do it. Mark, we usually come to you for betting advice in these types of matchups. What do you have for this game?
Yeah, so you kind of hinted at where I'm going with my player prop. But before I get to that, as far as the spread, you said it's even right now. I'm taking the Lakers with the even money. Ooh. On the spread, money line, whatever you want to do. Lakers will win this game. For all the things I mentioned earlier, I think they take care of the glass. I think they stop them in transition, make the Grizzlies score in the half court. And to my player prop, another reason why I think they're going to win this game, last game, LeBron was kind of chilling offensively. He only had 21 points. He only shot the ball 16 times. He's averaging 22 shot attempts on the season. So that's six less than his average in game one. He shot 16 times. And I think a lot of that obviously has to do with Rui got going. Obviously, late in the fourth, Austin Reeves got going. But I think tonight, you know, you could probably expect a little regression for those guys. Not to say they're going to play bad, but I don't see Rui scoring 20-plus points again. Austin Reeves probably doesn't score 20-plus points again tonight either, which means LeBron's going to be a little bit more aggressive tonight. So I'm taking his over on points at 26.5.
I like it. I like it. I do agree. I think we're going to see a little bit more scoring from LeBron, a little more scoring from Anthony Davis. Hopefully they can get the job done here. Again, I think this is a big opportunity here for the Lakers. So far around the NBA, we saw last night, both teams that had a chance to go up 2-0 on the road, the Clippers and the Knicks, failed to do so. 1-1 series going back to the next location there. Hopefully the Lakers can take advantage where those teams did not and go back to LA with a 2-0 series lead. That would be absolutely massive. But again, Lakers Nation, give us your thoughts in the comments down below. What do the Lakers need to do in order to get the job done against the Grizzlies? Early start time, don't forget, 4:30 Pacific time start for this game. Again, come join us over on playback.tv/Lakers Nation. Till next time, everybody. See ya and stay safe.